You're definitely in the midst of a severe drought. With quail, you're really counting on those rainfall events to trigger pairing and nest initiation. But with no ground moisture, a lot of times those birds will just keep that energy in reserve and just try and stay alive to the next year. The reproductive effort for bobwhite quail was pretty much non-existent.
Bobwhite quail numbers in Texas have been declining at a rate of nearly 4% each year since 1970, mostly due to habitat loss. And Texas bobwhite harvest has declined by 80% in the last three decades.
Got them.
History shows that bobwhites can bounce back when the weather cooperates and there is suitable habitat. But the ongoing drought and frequent summer wildfires have Texas Parks and Wildlife looking at some possible changes in hunting regulations for the next year. Regulation changes would be just one piece of the puzzle in recovering the species.
Looking really good, looking real clumpy. I bet y'all been seeing some quail in here, haven't you?
Biologists are also working with landowners to develop habitat-based management strategies that can benefit quail and other grassland wildlife.
Let's go up here and we'll walk down this strip.
And with hunting season for quail just underway, biologists are asking landowners who are seeing low numbers on their ranch to consider reducing quail harvest.
And the numbers are down from last year in every region except for the Gulf Coast. Production actually was up from last year.
Annual quail populations can change dramatically in just 2 years.
One of the benefits of quail is that they are so quick to reproduce, and when the good times come, when it does start to rain again, and it will, they'll be ready to react quickly and they'll double, triple their numbers.
For Texas Parks and Wildlife, this is Lydia Saldana.